Shalom, shalom. You're highly welcome, my dear brothers and sisters out there. I'm glad that you just clicked to watch this particular message. Today, I'm going to be talking about the transition and the works, the wars, and the spiritual warfare that is being undertaken against the people who are descendant in this particular paradigm. Now, you need to be able to really understand what is going on, because remember what the scripture have said, that we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against rulers of darkness, against spiritual wickedness that are in high places. Now I want us to be able to understand something which is very, very important. A lot of people do not understand the strategies and the way that the enemy works in order to really fulfill this particular means of them, you know, when the Bible talk about principalities and powers, how do these principalities and power manipulate over the people? How do the principalities, because these are things which when you understand and know how principalities and powers manipulate over people, then you would be able to also know how to be able to escape and also escape from their own traps, which they have trapped. And now this is very, very key and important for you to be able to understand, because you are in a battle. A lot of people did not understand that they descended down here. And as they descended down here, they came here with some spiritual powers. And what I mean by spiritual powers is that you possess actually, spiritually, a power that is unique to your own mission in this particular paradigm. But there's something that you need to be able to understand. The same way that you descended is the same way that some other entities also descended. Now, there is something that is going on now. People are all, you know, a lot of people now, or a lot of beings have descended in this particular paradigm. And the purpose is to be able to do what? To catapult themselves. Actually, they descended in order to ascend back. Now, I want you to understand this. The descension is for them to be able to descend. The purpose of the descension is for them to be able to get what they need in order for them to ascend back into a higher form or higher version of themselves. So they descended in order for them to ascend. So, but there is something here now. A lot of people who descended having a spiritual power before their descension, which for you being able to manifest or descend here in the physical form as a human, I want you to be able to understand, it's already showing you, this is a sign. This is something that is already showing you that you are a supernatural being. That is the reason why, for you being in the image of this, you know, in this image of what they call humans, is already an ID that is showing you that you are a supernatural being that is coming from a supernatural place, a superior place, a higher version of energy of you, and now you are manifesting. So your manifestation in this physical form as a human shows that you have so much energy that warranted you in order for you to be here in the form of a human. Animals do not have this kind of energy that you possesses in order to for them to be here. So this is the reason why they, when you talk about different animals like cows, like elephants, like dogs, like all these kind of different animals, right? These animals did not possess this kind of amount of energy that you humans possesses, and this is the reason why they are being seen as classified animals. That is literally, they are classified spirits because they did not possess enough energy that would have warranted them in order for them to be in the human form. But you are in this particular vehicle or in this human form because you possessed a power from the spiritual realm, from the spiritual power, from the spiritual realm which had made you in order for you to be manifested in this realm of reality in the human form. But there is something that you need to be able to understand. The same way that you that is manifested in this form, in this physical plane, in this avatar as a human, is equally the same way that different entities or different beings were able to do what to equally manifest. Now, there is something that you need to be able to understand. You have descended, or you have descended here in order for you to ascend back into another form that is higher than this particular body that you are inhabiting on. I want you to understand what is really going on. So since you have descended in this physical form, in this avatar, in this body, because you are a powerful being from the spirit realm manifested in this physical, you equally now, you are traveling, you are making a journey towards that eternal eternity, right? You are going on an eternal journey, and that eternal journey, you equally needed. You need a body, an avatar, which is more expensive, than this particular body that you are in, which is more. So you got to be able to do what to attain to the amount of energy needed in order for you to be in that body where you are going to. I want you to understand that, because the certain place where you are going to, in that particular place, the people who do not have enough energy cannot be in those forms. Just like I said, that so many people, as you came here in the image or in this particular way of what is called a human, it is not a coincidence, it's not by accident. Something happened that helped you to be manifested in this physical plane as a human. But there is something also that is going on in this world that you see. This is why I want you to be able to understand. Those principalities and the powers which are in this third dimensional realm, there are people who descended down here the same way that you descended. So now what happened is that they have come within this third dimensional paradigm. And you know what? They did not have any other longer higher energy in order that is going to help drive them into the next level or into a next avatar. So what did this particular entities do is that they decided to make this particular place their home. So these people who have decided to make this particular place their home, these are called principalities. And so why they made this particular place, I want you to understand, is that while they have made this particular place their home, all what they are going to be feeding off is what are people, are things which are descending, people who are descending, who actually should have had a vision, a mission of what, of going into a higher dimension or higher, attaining a higher body. So, but those people who have already decided to be here, and now this is like their ghettos, and you have a lot who have descended. So their own purpose, those people who are here now, their own purpose is going to be doing everything within, they are going to be doing everything within their reach in order for them to be able to do what, to trap those people who are coming here that are supposed to be ascending into another, you know, into a higher version of what, of avatar, into a higher version of what, their own body. Because you need to be able to understand that the body that you are going to be inhabiting, you are building it by you coming through this particular body. You are having the opportunity, each person that is coming through this particular body structure, physical body structure, is here having the opportunity in order to be here and be, so that he can be able to do what? To build a higher version of what? Of his own body. Now, what I'm saying is that when you look at the moon, you look at the sun, you look at the stars that are in the heavenly bodies, these things are all heavenly. These are called heavenly bodies. These are called heavenly bodies. Remember what the scripture said, that before something happened, that is literally before you can be able to, just like in the world, in the secular world, when you bring in an apple tree or whatsoever, and then you plant those particular three, what happened to those seed first? They first decay, and the decaying, when they spring out, the same fruit that you took and then you sowed is not the same one that is going to spring out. That is, it looks different from what you have sown in. So what I want you to be able to understand, my dear brothers and sisters, is this. We are talking about the journey of life. That you have descended here, that is, now you have been sown in this particular body. And now that you have been sown in this particular body, you are on a journey in attaining a higher version of this body that you are seeing. And it is that higher version of this body that you are seeing. It is that one that has the power to do what? To produce seeds. And it is that one. That one, there is no such thing. This is what you need to be able to understand. That one is what is a whole being. The one that you're seeing can be separated. Can be separated from one another. So this is why when you see things that has to do with a feminine and the masculine, you know, which is a role that is being played in this particular paradigm, you know, in order for you to be able to even see and wake up to the reality of what is going on. So my brothers and sisters, what I'm saying is that you need to be able to understand that in this particular paradigm, there are entities who have come down here and now made this place their home. So since they have made this place their home, it's like those people, they are lazy. They are lazy entities, they are lazy beings, they are lazy ones who have decided not to make a higher journey to get a higher body. So what did they decide to do? They decide to make here their ghetto. And as a result, this is why you see people talk about, you know, others selling their soul. And so when they sell their soul, they become an agent. They become an agent to those people, to those beings who are to ascend back, because these people have decided. They have decided that they are going to be within this paradigm. They have decided that they are going to be the entities which are going to be used within this third dimensional paradigm to prevent you from ascending up, despite what. So they are being paid. They are being given things which they want in order for them to be able to do this work. And this work is the, they are being used as an instrument, as an agent, in order to suck the energy of those people who have descended, so that when the energy of those people who have descended is being sucked, those entities who suck this particular energy are going to channel this energy to other beings, to the beings who are controlling them. So now they are using them in order to trap beings who are coming in here, who are supposed to be ascending while here, so that they can attain their own, you know, higher powers or higher bodies. Because this world you are seeing, this is why, you know, they bring in things that has to do with what, with fear of death. Now they are doing it in order to put people under duress, or literally under, you know, under fear, for you to be afraid of something that you really did not have a good understanding over. But by the time that you begin to have a deeper knowledge and understanding about how things work and how the entities and the agents of this dark world operate within the dark world, then that would give you, that would open your eyes in order for you to escape their traps. Because all you see here is all massive nature of what, of energy vampires. And that is the reason why the Bible says, for we wrestle not against flesh and blood. It's not about the flesh, it's about your spiritual power, my brothers and sisters. It is about the spiritual power that you possess, that even made you to be manifested in this form, as a, in the form of a human. So many people who appeared in this form as a form of a human, they would not have the power to be able to do what, to continue this particular journey, because why? Their energy was being sucked down here. And what is going to happen in the next world, or in the next journey of the worlds, Because we're talking about parallel worlds. In the next journey of the worlds, they are going to appear in the form of what, of a goat or a cow or an animal. So it is important that you really need to be able to understand the strategies and how the enemies, how the principalities, how the powers of this darkness are after your own spiritual powers. So this is why the Bible is saying, for you wrestle not against flesh and blood. It is not against flesh. It is against your spiritual abilities. And that spiritual ability is what needs you to manifest in this paradigm, like I said, as a what they call a human. You manifested here. It is not by chance as a human. There is something that you did. Something happened. You came. You a lot of other entities manifested the same in this particular time as what, as cows, as animals, as goats, as different other animals, as dogs. Some have to manifest in those forms because they did not have the ability. They did not have enough energy that is going to, that is, they did not have enough energy which to pay for this particular vehicle that you're seeing. The vehicle is very expensive. And that is what is going to happen in the world to come. There are going to be people who are going to be possessing a certain avatar, a certain body, and those body cost so much energy. But these principalities, these powers, these rulers of the dark world are here to prevent you or to suck those energy from you. And this is why the Bible says, for you do not wrestle against those them flesh and blood. It's not about flesh and blood, but against powers, against rulers of darkness, against spiritual wickedness in high places. It is all about trapping people, trapping souls down here. This is the reason why you see them creating all kind of things. And they sell, they are getting a lot of agents. Even if you do not know, you might be an agent of this dark world. Because what happened is that they put people down in order for them not to be able to really see the potentials which is ahead of them. Which they are, the purpose of what they have come in order to actualize, and the things which is far beyond their own imagination. So they tend to be able to do what, to keep them within a cycle. And as long as those people cannot think outside of the cycle, the principalities and powers are going to do what, continue using them and sucking their energy. And this is one thing that you need to be able to understand, my dear brothers and sisters, that we are here in order to elevate our brothers and sisters, to show them the way. And that way is the way of eternal life. And that way is a way of endless life. And that way is a journey, is the way of endless eternity. And that way is to let you know that you are from somewhere and you came down here. And as you are here, your journey is not yet done. You are on a course. You are on a journey to attaining to another level of what, of realities. And that level, for you to exist in that world, you need a body. And the body that you need, somebody got to do what, you have to have enough energy in order for you to live in a mansion. If you don't have enough energy, how can you live in a certain mansion? If you don't have enough energy, how is, so what do you really understand when Yahushua, when the Bible says that Yahuwah is going to supply all your need according to his riches in glory, according to his riches in glory, that is according to what you have stored in the spirit realm. You got to work things out. The enemies are here. I'm telling you, the principalities are here. They have decided to be, here is going to be their domain. So they are not going to be leaving this particular body, because they are going to be recycled, used as an agent in order to prevent those who need to get out here. And so this is why a lot of people, I'm telling you, you are spiritually on a war zone. So you got to wake up, my dear brothers and sisters. And these things are real. These things are real. This is why the Bible says, put on the whole armor, which is what, the word of truth, the knowledge, because you need to understand that knowledge, true knowledge, is power. I pray, may the Most High, whose name is Yahuwah, elevate my brothers and sisters and open up their understanding and their spiritual knowledge and eyes for them to see the Baruch that is ahead. Because the Bible say, I know the thought that I think towards you, the thought of good and not of evil, to give you an expected end. Do not let the energy suckers trap you down here, because they have decided they don't have no energy to move on. So they are looking for energies to trap down here so that they themselves can survive in this world which they are in. No wonder they keep on recycling them. But you are on a journey, and that journey that you are going, you would attain as long as you take heed to the word of advice. And this is the message. I pray, may the Most High elevate each and every one of you. In the name of Yahushua. Shalom, my dear brothers and sisters out there.